McMillan Audio presents Beyond the Known, Realization, a channel text, Book 1 of the Beyond the Known Trilogy by Paul Selig, read for you by the author, with a foreword read by Aubrey Marcus.
Foreword. I consider myself an open-minded skeptic. When my friends and mentors Ted Decker and Duncan Trussell recommended that I listen to the channeled teachings of Paul Selig, I casually tuned into a podcast. Paul seemed like a humble, genuine guy. I noticed no indication of bravado or any desire to wear the mask of spiritual master. It was when he started the process of channeling, everything became very interesting. He would quickly mumble parts of a sentence and then repeat them again clearly and audibly. As I listened further, I became more and more intrigued. The message that he was offering was, well, impeccable. I had never heard a more salient expression of truth from any spiritual teacher, alive or dead. I was astounded. It was enough to put me on the path to discovering more. I immediately dove into his channeled books. That is when the teaching really started to shift my perspective. I began to comprehend my own potential to grasp highly evolved concepts. My experience with this work in a few short months had been more profound than anything I had known prior. I was determined to meet Paul in person. I invited him to come to my office for a podcast at the Onnit headquarters in Austin, Texas. While Onnit is focused on the body and the mindset of peak performance, my personal passion is the expansion of consciousness. And this often takes me deep into the uncharted realms of spirituality. This was the start of a genuine friendship with Paul and a dedication to learn as much as I possibly could from the teaching of the guides. I was fortunate enough to get an early copy of the Book of Freedom, which took me even further in my understanding of my questions of who I am, what I am, and how I serve. Perhaps the most important questions of any spiritual philosophy. Learning from the guides has not only taught me a great deal, it has also provided a language for many of the truths that I have discovered from over 20 years of experiential work. Everything I have come to know from my dedication to plant medicine, breathwork, yoga, and meditation was all consistent with these teachings. The goal of my personal work has always been to become free. Free to experience love and the bliss of existing in true presence. Free to experience pain without the mental resistance that creates suffering. Free to experience the connection to everyone and everything around me without judgment. Free to know myself beyond my personal history and identity. So when Paul asked me if I would like to read his latest work, Beyond the Known Realization, and write the foreword, there wasn't a moment's hesitation. Not only was that a great honor, it was a treat to get an early copy of his latest manuscript. This book is the most audacious of the guide's teachings to date. It describes how anyone who chooses can claim the true expression of who they are, what the guides call the divine self, the true self, or the Christed self. From my personal experience, it is important to take your time with the teachings. Trust that your path will follow the perfect timing and teaching for you and you alone. And while you are in the process, recognize that just because you are doing this work, it doesn't make your path any better or worse than anyone else's. Those are all judgments that you can't bring with you on this journey. We're all together in the school of life. I can't say that after reading this book that I am a permanent resident of what the guides call the upper room, but I have gazed out of those sun-soaked windows for a few moments. Moments that in Zen Buddhism they would call satori, And having seen that view, I find myself happier, less fearful, and much more abundant in love. I hope you have the same experience. I have no doubt that you will. Aubrey Marcus, New York Times bestselling author of Own the Day, Own Your Life, and founder and CEO of On It.
The following are the unedited transcripts of recordings of channeled lectures delivered through Paul Selig in workshops and seminars held in New York City, New York, Atlanta, Georgia, London, England, Ann Arbor, Michigan, Rhinebeck, New York, Madison, Wisconsin, Santa Barbara, California, Portland, Oregon, Seattle, Washington, Boone, North Carolina, and Calgary, Alberta, between May 19, 2018, and August 26, 2018. Prologue. Day 1. Now the ambassador of truth, come as you, will claim a world in a new vibration. The ambassador of truth being the one who knows who she is and has affirmed her place in the kingdom being the awareness of the divine in all she sees. The manifest world is more than a projection. In some ways, it's the collective agreement to be what it needs to be at the level of vibration that it has been confirmed in by name. The names you have gifted things claim form: a chair, a rock, a tree, a roof. These are all things that have been named that confirm the names they have been given. But a treetop may be something other than what it's been conceived of. A house may be a house, not for man, but for clouds. Everything you see may be known anew from the high vantage point where we intend to take you. The right to be was gifted to you at the inception of your soul. The right to be cannot be taken from you. It is not dependent upon the life you live, the adherence to rules, the diplomas on the wall, the pedigree of birth. It is not dependent on what you have believed yourself to be. The right to be is confirmed by the octave that you find yourself expressing in. And by octave we mean the level of resonance and energetic accord that you have bound yourself to. As we lift you, one and all, to the high room, to the high level of agreement that can be understood and experienced while embodied, we will take you where you can go for the sole purpose of realization. What does it mean, he, Paul, asks, that we can know? As long as the body is in density, there are levels of awareness that will preclude you from admittance. But as the body expresses itself more and more in the high vibration, even those become apparent to the eye. The reclamation of the divine as what, in field and form, is the teaching you receive. And, in order to enter the upper room, you cannot leave the body behind, the body that seems to fail you, that doesn't look as it should, that is riddled with cancer, or in fear of what could happen to it. Nothing can be released until it is known. Nothing can be re-known until it is first considered at the level of vibration that it has claimed for itself. So we intend to bring you all, wherever you sit, whatever you sit as, to the level of agreement that may hold you and support you in perceiving the self, in acknowledging the self as an inhabitant of the upper room. Now, what the upper room is, in some ways, is a creation. Everything, in fact, that exists and may exist or could exist one day is a creation of consciousness. Nothing exists without this. So the idealization of the upper room, while unnecessary, may support you only in one way. It is where you arrive to in consequence of the vibratory accord that you have claimed an alignment to. Imagine you have a jukebox and you punch two numbers in. A certain song will play. The coordinates for the upper room are as present as thus, and you may return here whenever you claim it. But to abide in the upper room is to maintain the vibration that has brought you here, and not collect the old, the twigs of the past fires, still broken, and attempt to ignite them in the higher place. The smoke from them will evacuate you quickly. You only bring to the upper room what you carry, and what you don't need will be brought back to where it came from, in the oasis of this plane that has known itself in all kinds of ways. The crisis you may face here, if you have to have one, is that what you seek as a small self may not be found here. Bring me to the place of no pain, to no awareness, or bring me all awareness as long as the awareness feels good. From the perspective of the upper room, you will actually be of benefit to your world, but you will also see with new eyes what man has done to man, what humanity has wrought through fear, and how you have claimed yourself as a small self, as a separate entity from the source of your being, and the perils you have claimed for humanity and this plane of expression that you may call Earth. Now, as we sing to you, and by song we mean resonance, and the language we endow with purpose, expression, and accord, we sing for you to bring you to us at the level of agreement that you can adhere to. To bring you to the upper room simply requires you to consent and to be lifted. To have the simple experience of it is to align the self to the presence of what already is. You are not making anything happen. You are accepting what is, exists, at the top of the stairway in the upper room. The claim you make, "I am free, I am free, I am free," as sung through the resonant field, is what will reclaim you here. Because this is the room of freedom, where you are not bound by what you have thought or consented to as a small being in consent with others who are consenting to the same. "What does that mean?" he asks. "Adherence to law. Adherence to the prescriptions of time. Adhering to what you have been taught to expect at the denial of what is. These are the things you no longer align to in the upper room. They are present in the lower octave, may be understood there, played out there, seen through there, and to see through means to claim to completion. To align to the higher at the cost of the old is to begin to have an experience of no limitation, of freedom beyond the known, beyond what you've consented to as an individual living in a tapestry or an echo that is, in fact, a shared creation. So when we do this with you, we do this for several reasons. Because we prefer to teach now without the opposition that the small self likes to claim, we invite you to the place where such opposition is not present, because the fear that would be at its basis is not present in the upper room. And as we teach you here, and as you learn here, as you are reclaimed here, the seeking of justification for the old ways begins to peel from you. Imagine shingles falling from an old roof. The attic is exposed. The upper room is exposed, and there is nothing to separate you from the great sky beyond. The great sky beyond. All that is of God and may be known as God exists all around you in the cloud of love, the cloud of remembrance that supports you in lifting again and again to what may be realized beyond the known. The song we sing for you today, and will continue to sing, will be heralded in the new text, Beyond the Known. And, as we sing it, as we announce the text in language, in tone, we support you each in your reliance on the divine that is you, that has always been you, that can only be you, that is here, that is here, that is here. As we lift you each to the upper room where this class may convene again and again, we offer you the opportunity to say, no, thank you. I wish to abide in the lower floors. I wish to stay where I have been in the resonant field of fear, in the opportunities that fear brings me to learn in the old ways. You may choose to stay where you are. You are loved as you are. You cannot fail here. But, if you give it permission, the self-permission, to claim the truth of who you have always been, we will lift you to the new classroom, and from here we will teach you. When we count to three, we are going to invite you each to see a stairwell before you. When you see the stairwell, we will invite you forward to climb the stairs that appear. And, as the count of three is made, the energies that you require to support you in this ascension will be called forth for you. 1, 2, 3. See the stairway before you and allow us to bring you forth, to lift you to the upper room. On the count of three, we invite you to climb the stairs, and with each step, you may consent to the following. 1. I am willing to release the idea of who I am or what I have been to receive the new. 2. I am willing to release the attachments I have had or may still have to what I think I am or should be. 3. I accept myself as worthy of this passage. Because I was born, I may be known anew. And because I am sung in vibration through these words, I know who I am in truth. I know what I am in truth. I know how I serve in truth. I may receive the gift of the kingdom that awaits for me on the other side of the threshold. On the count of three, see a doorway before you, and as the tone we sing is sung, you may join us in vibration and step over the threshold to what waits before you. 1, 2, 3. Step over the threshold and be with us. Feel this, yes. I know who I am in truth. Say this. I know what I am in truth. I know how I serve in truth. I am free. I am free. I am free. Be received by us. Feel what it is like to be at this level of expression. Be as you are. Be as you are. Be as you are. Thank you and stop now, please. Period, period, period. Day 2. Now, when you ask us questions about what you want, you refer to the histories you've had to determine what you should have, what should be aspired to, what you should want because of the kind of person you are. The kind of person you are in evolution is evolving beyond what you have thought, and to claim the old, to predetermine the new, is to sacrifice the potential that is awaiting.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.